I will be speaking on surgical tips and tricks for complicated pediatric cataract surgery. It is well
sir,
said
sir,
that...
Excuse me, sir. I think this is a different presentation probably. How does it start? This is because it has some background music in this.
Background music is there, but this is the same, I think, surgical...
Sir, what is the title?
Surgical tips and tricks for complicated pediatric cataract surgery.
I guess the problem is that with this presentation and this slide, Dr. Jagat might have zoomed in the presentation. So if you could zoom it out and make it normal, that would be fine.
Sir, please share again, sir.
Yeah, I think we will share it again.
Yes. Yes, sir. Now it's fine.
Now it's fine.
Yes,
perfect, sir.
So that was a PGI presentation which you showed you.
Yeah, okay. This is surgical tips and tricks for complicated pediatric cataracts. If we fail to prepare, then we should assume that you will prepare to fail. This is well said, because if you are not prepared, so you have to prepare every time. So for pediatric cataract surgery, you have to diagnose the case, then you have to plan the case. There may be several situations. You have to do some innovative surgical procedure. You have to execute the procedure. And after surgery, you have to follow up these patients. Because there may be several of the complicated situations which I am going to show, such as PSPV, double crystalline lens, microphthalmos, boophthalmos. So this is a case with posterior lenticonus. This is a 2-year-old child with lenticonus. And this is anterior continuous curvilinear capsular axis. This is the removal of the cortex from the capsular back. This came out to be, this was the posterior lenticonus. So in these patients, we have to do primary posterior capsulotomy and place the IOL in the capsular back, and then remove whatever vitreous is there, and it is much more precisely removed by triamcinolone injection into anterior chamber. Another situation, this is a 4-month-old child. This was 4 months in 2013. Now this child is more than 7 years. And here two continuous curvilinear capsular axis were done. Removal of the cortex from the capsular back. And we implanted customized IOL, because such a large IOL not available anywhere in the market. And both the haptics were implanted into back. And this is the final picture. The child amblyopia therapy was initiated, and the child could see even the smallest object. So occlusion therapy is extremely important in these children. Then comes high corneal astigmatism with cataract. This is a child with zonular cataract. Marking was done, and Callisto was used. Continuous curvilinear capsular axis. Removal of the cortex from the capsular bag. And then this toric IOL implanted in the capsular bag. So Callisto was used here. And it has to be perfect alignment in the axis. this is a perfect alignment, and then hybridization of the section. This is another child, JIA, 14-year-old girl, and here synecdoche was done. Then Malleugin ring is placed. For adequate dilatation of the pupil. Staining make the rexis easier, and then removal of the cortex from the back, and then implantation of the IR into capsular bag. Then removal of this Malleugin ring. And most of the time, or many times in a uveitic patient, we do peripheral iodectomy. Here is another child, 4-year-old child with congenital lenticular coloboma. For stabilization of the bag, we made this flap, and synecdoche was done. Anterior continuous curvilinear capsular axis. And this is the capsular hooks which can be placed along the capsular axis. Then removal of the cortex from the capsular bag. And then passing of this polypropylene suture. And a single islet Sioni ring. And then we, in this case, implanted a toric IR. Then these hooks are removed. And it provided excellent centration of the IOL and good stability. And this is before and after surgery in the same case. This is another child where there was cataract, and a child already had glaucoma surgery with tube. This glaucoma drainage device much longer than required, and pupil was small. Malleugin ring placed, removal of the cortex from the capsular bag, and then implantation of the IOL. Most of the time at present, we place a single piece IOL, but many times three piece IOL. And then trimming of this tube, which was much longer than required. Removal of the viscoelastic substance from the anterior chamber and from behind the lens. This is a child with the hemorrhagic type of PHPV, and we can see the stalk also. The axis has been done. Then cauterization of the vascularized membrane. Only where not very common to find these hemorrhagic type of PHPV. Removal of this vascularized membrane after cauterization. We use this Utrata, a small vena seizure. Cauterization of the stalk, otherwise it may bleed. Cutting and removing it using vitrectomy cutter, because there may be traction. Then Then placing the eye oil, it has to be captured. But this is a simple capture done here. Removal of the viscoelastic. And these are some of the other pictures showing where we have done cataract surgery in patients with the PHPV. So this is, in short, we have made the presentation on managing complicated pediatric cataracts.